Good morning. I'm honored to sit on the Exposed Facts Advisory Board with so many extraordinary, distinguished whistleblowers who have persevered in the face of state-sponsored intimidation and harassment. My contribution to the board will focus on helping environmental and civil rights whistleblowers expose corruption in the federal government. For me, this is not an academic exercise. I have been in the trenches as an EPA whistleblower for decades, and I bring this hard-won experience to the board. At the dawn of the Nelson Mandela administration, I had the extraordinary experience of sitting at the table with the ANC leadership at the Environmental Protection Agency White House liaison to the Mandela government on environmental affairs. My job was to work with the new ANC government to design and provide U.S. technical environmental expertise to assist the majority population's recovery from the environmental and public health disaster left by apartheid. This process took place through the flagship foreign policy vehicle called the U.S. South Africa Binational Commission, commonly called the Gorembeki Commission, or the BNC. A detailed description and analysis of these events can be found in my book called No Fear, A Whistleblower's Triumph Over Corruption and Retaliation at the EPA, and numerous articles in the Black Agenda Report. I was the U.S. official to whom the first reports of illness and deaths relating to vanadium pentoxide mining were given by Black South African union leaders initially and later by the new Mandela government. Vanadium is the metal that allows steel the ability to expand and contract our cars, trucks, airplanes, this microphone, forks and spoons and knives, surgical equipment, all depend on vanadium doing its job. We as a society depend on the South African vanadium miners that risk their lives every day so that we can live in an affluent society. Unfortunately, the miners are still dying, and someone must be held accountable for this. We know what happens to miners who are exposed to vanadium. In the long term, they die. But before that final event, their tongues turn a bright green. They develop bronchitis, asthma. They bleed from every orifice in the body. There is impotence in young, healthy male workers, cancers, and ultimately death. This is what I reported to the EPA. This is what I reported to the White House. And I was given a direct order to shut up. And I said no. I made the decision to disobey a direct order. The retaliation was brutal and unrelenting, and I became the target of death threats and rape threats. I took the EPA to court, and remarkably, I won. After congressional hearings, Congressman F. James Sensenbrenner and Congresswoman Sheila Jackson Lee introduced the No Fear Act. And after years of excruciating struggle by federal workers, many of whom were fired and targets of incredible harassment, the No Fear Act was passed on May 26, 2002, and it was the first civil rights and whistleblower law of the 21st century. And I wish I could report that the No Fear Act was a panacea against repression in the federal government, but this is not how the system works. In my case, the retaliation intensified, and 4 years after I won my federal case and provided leadership for the passage of the No Fear Act, I was fired. So I go back to court in a couple of months to prove that the agency fired me because I blew the whistle on EPA corruption and retaliation. More importantly, I go back to court to prove that EPA is a hostile environment for truth tellers, and the facts coming out of my case will be terribly embarrassing for the agency, reportedly committed to saving the planet. I have a message to EPA Administrator Gina McCarthy. You know, you can break from the despicable tradition at EPA of retaliating against whistleblowers left by the likes of Carol Browner and most recently Lisa Jackson, and you can chart a new course where EPA environmental scientists committed to transparency and openness will know that they are safe to report environmental dangers to the American public without having their lives and careers ripped apart. I ask you, the press, to continue to follow my case and other whistleblowers because they instruct the American public about how the U.S. government operates at the cellular level. It is EPA whistleblowers who warn the public about lead in the water and arsenic in food, about the noncompliance of vital legislation that could reduce asthma in the very young and the elderly. And so I have decided to blow the whistle again at this press conference because the American public has a right to know. In 2002, the United States government said enough is enough to a system-wide discrimination and retaliation by passing unanimously in both houses the No Fear Act. We knew at the time of its passage that it would be only the first step. Significantly, this law mandates that every government agency must post No Fear statistics on its homepage, providing a scientific measuring tool for monitoring compliance brought against discriminating officials. And guess what? In the decades since the No Fear Act was passed, the government has spent, would anyone like to hazard a guess how much the government has spent protecting discriminating and retaliating officials? Yes?
Nothing.
No, no, how much they've spent protecting themselves.
Oh.
How much they've spent protecting, discriminating, and retaliating officials.
$1 billion.
Exactly. The United States government has spent, in fact, it is actually over $1 billion. And the reason why it's going to top the $1 billion is because the Department of Justice has refused to release how much money they pay their lawyers to go after whistleblowers in the federal government. And we have now asked Congressman Sensenbrenner and Congressman Sheila Jackson Lee to use the power of their office to get us this information. So it's going to go well over $1 billion. This represents just the tip of the iceberg. By virtue of this data, there is no longer any place for the rascals to hide. We've got their number. We've got their number. So I call on Congress to hold hearings that expose these managers for what they are, criminals. And I call on the President to endorse the passage of No Fear 2. Instead of burning $1 billion to protect criminals inside the federal government, instead we must be able to rid the federal government of managerial criminals. Because of No Fear 1, we now have the numbers. And we need the President, and more importantly, we need the public to act. So again, I'm very proud to be a part of the Exposed Facts Advisory Board, and I look forward to working with other whistleblowers to expose corruption in the U.S. government. And I encourage federal workers with information on corruption to report through the website provided by Exposed Facts. Thank you.